and we'll be back on Saturday night. Very much, and fans, don't forget, exclusive, never-before-seen footage still remaining in this television program. What happened when Nitro went off the air this past Monday when Eric Bischoff and Sting were still in the ring? Plus, the Steiners, the Amazing French Canadians, and we'll take you back to Nitro and show you the brutal attack Ric Flair sustained at the hands of the NWO.
Right, yeah, and...
All right, Jimmy Hart and Ming. And you know, of the great matches we had at Slambury, it was a great night. It was a dead T-Ranchula trying to get a quick start on Ming. Maybe not a bad idea. And Benoit, obviously obsessed with Kevin Sullivan, or he wouldn't take a match like he had to endure the other night.
Yeah, and he had to endure some heavy punishment. And it was a matchup to be remembered for a long time. Yeah.
Look at this drop toe.
Well, now he's back on top of him. You're in a bad spot when you face down and Ming is on top of you. Brutalizing. Brutalizing it.
Our fans who watched Saturday night a week ago and the pro on Sunday realized that Benoit had told woman, do not go in the towel. There came that moment in the midst of that tongue and death grip where she almost wanted to, and he shook his head no.
Yeah.
And Benoit, certainly one of the most fearless, one of the bravest men our sport's ever seen. He went into this death match knowing what he was in store for, and I think he's blinded by his hatred towards Kevin Sullivan.
I was just going to say that. When you are so blinded by a hatred that you can't see in front of you, if you're so blinded by really what's important, I guarantee you this thing with Sullivan has not only taken its toll, but really damaged himself physically and career-wise.
That's right.
Because titles were at hand for him.
Oh, boy.
He represented one of the top groups ever in the history, the Four Horsemen. All of these things are still in tow. But, man, you cannot react when you're getting beat up and you are beaten up. Everything that happened with the Sullivan situation, yeah. I mean, it really has taken its toll on him mentally, physically, and I don't know morally, but it's there. They got him. They got him, Tonga.
They got him. The tongue and death grip is on,
yeah.
And this maybe, I guess I shouldn't say maybe, truly one of the most feared men our sport's ever seen. Ming dominates again. Look at Jimmy
Hart. You know how to stomp out a tarantula that's calling across the floor.
I guess that's the way you do it.
Yeah, tongue and death grip. Jimmy Hart trying to talk him out of it.
And he just balked at it.
Yeah, look at it. Boy, his intensity has really turned up a notch, hasn't it?
You can tell that Jimmy Hart's afraid of the man.
Sure,
well,
he is.
Who isn't?
Right.
I mean,
wow.
He truly is a fighting machine and a destruction machine. Jimmy Hart says, all right, calm down, let's go.
Yeah.
And actually, Jimmy Hart's not leading here, he's following.
Yeah, and like you said, that kick right there put him out. The tongue and death trip. Death grip. I say trip. Put him out. Got him. Laid him to waste right here. The attitude change in Ming has made him more devastating than ever.
It's our Valvoline replay. People who know use Valvoline. Back after this.